And recently I had a sister who sent me a post on Instagram from Judah Awakens 28. And it's about a post in which they said that King David was Browne. And when I went to the post and seen it said the Great Bible in 1539, so I went to Google, and then it took me to Texas Receptus Bibles. I typed in the Great Bible 59. I scrolled up and I looked for 1 Samuel, as you can see. Then, you know what I mean, I went to chapter 16, scrolled down to the verse, which pull it up right now. And you can see verse 16:12, and it reads, and he sent and brought him in, and he was brown of an excellent beauty and well favored in sight. And the Lord said, arise and anoint him, for this is he. Therefore Samuel took the horn with the ointment and anointed him in the midst of his brethren, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward, and Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. All right, so when you look at the Great Bible of 1539, which is an earlier translation than the King James Version, you see that it's read that David was brown, right? Now, you know, a lot of people will say, oh, it's ruddy. It means ruddy. So now let's go to the King James, and I want to show you what the King James says. Okay, so when we read the same scriptures in 1 Samuel 16, verses 12 through 13 in the King James Version, you'll see. Verse 12, and it says, and he sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy. See, so that's where it says he was ruddy or brown. And with all of a good, beautiful countenance, and goodly to look to, and the Lord said, arise, anoint him, for this is he. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. Okay, so now I want to show you a Bible, the oldest Ethiopian Bible, and they had depictions in there, and I want you to see this.
Their own style in every century, so that one can study these different styles with different. Look, this is King David. You know, the servants are standing by, and then not only that, they have, you know, we call it chira, you know, to protect flies from the king. They hold here, and look, not only they hold, you know, the chiras, but they have combs in their hair, you know, hairstyle. Look, you know, they have combs. And you know the crown of, you know, the king, typical Ethiopian type of crown, and you know debab, we call it this debab, is, you know, big umbrella, and seated king. So as I told you, look how they dressed, you know. So this is very important for sociology and anthropology, you know, to study.
All right, next. So let's go and talk about the word ruddy. Okay, have you ever heard of a ruddy duck or a ruddy horse? So now let's look and see what a ruddy duck is. All right, so when we go to Google and type in ruddy duck, okay? This is the image that it'll show you, right? As you can see. And you see the color of the duck. The ruddy duck is a duck from North America and one of the stiff-tailed ducks, right? But you see what the color ruddy is, okay? Now let me show you a ruddy horse. All right, so we do the same thing. We type in a ruddy horse, and these are the images that it brings up, right? You can see that ruddy actually describes more of a brownish red complexion or brownish red color, okay? So that's why in that 1539 Bible, it says that he was brown. All right, so now when you look at the color ruddy and you see basically, you know, even in the English language, we see what color it actually depicts as being a brownish red. My complexion would be considered to be ruddy, right? If you look at the old Washington Redskins logo, let's take a look at it. All right, so next you see, we'll type in Redskin logo and then we'll go click on image. All right, and as you can see, look at the color that they have for the old Redskin logo. See how brown it is, right? So that's what really ruddy or red actually looks like, okay? All right, so but before I forget, that again, that Instagram is Judah Awakens 28. He puts out a lot of good stuff, you know, and he'll get different articles or different Bibles or whatever, and he puts out a lot of good information. So if you get a chance, go follow him on Instagram or even on Facebook. I think he's on Facebook too under Judah Awakens 28. But, you know, also, you know, I know people are going to say, well, what does it matter? What does skin color always matter? Right? The one thing that you have to understand about King David King David was a man after God's own heart, right? And it's about telling the truth. This ain't about color. You know what I'm saying? You know, this is about truth. And if you don't understand that, that's because you're a liar and there ain't no truth in you, right? But anyway, when it comes to talking about King David, we understand the one thing about David, when David was in the wrong, he always confessed his transgressions, right? And so for people that don't want to, you know, want to make excuses for, well, it don't mean this or it don't mean that. The one thing about King David, you're not like him, because David always confessed his transgressions, you know, and that's why he was a man after God's own heart. So no, is it really about color? No, it's about truth, right? And it's about your heart. But if you had a heart that is willing to tell lies, then you ain't, then you don't understand. All right. So now let's go close out with some scriptures and show how David was why he was a man after God's own heart. All right. So when we go to 2 Samuel chapter 12, verses 7 through 13, and it reads, "And Nathan said to David, thou art the man." This is when David had committed adultery with Bathsheba. And he said, "Thus saith the Lord God of Israel, I anointed thee king over Israel, and I delivered thee out of the hand of Saul. And I gave thee thy master's house and thy master's wives into thy bosom, and gave thee the house of Israel and of Judah. And if that had been too little, I would moreover have given unto thee such and such things. Wherefore hast thou despised the commandment of the Lord to do evil in his sight? Thou hast killed Uriah the Hittite with the sword, and hast taken his wife to be thy wife, and hast slain him with the sword of the children of Ammon. Now therefore the sword shall never depart from thine house, because thou hast despised me, and hast taken the wife of Uriah the Hittite to be thy wife. Thus saith the Lord, behold, I will raise up evil against thee out of thine own house, and I will take thy wives before thine eyes, and give them unto thy neighbor, and he shall lie with thy wives in the sight of this sun. And for thou didst secretly, but I will do this thing before all Israel and before the sun. And David said unto Nathan, I have sinned against the Lord. And Nathan said unto David, the Lord also hath put away thy sin, thou shalt not die. So you see, David confessed his sin, right? When he was told he had done something wrong, he didn't harden his heart. Now let me give you another example. All right, so in 2 Samuel chapter 24, we have another example of David's humble heart before the Lord, right? So David had went and numbered the people, and he wasn't supposed to do that, right? Basically took a census count. Well, anyway, in verse 10, it reads, "And David's heart smote him after that he had numbered the people. And David said unto the Lord, I have sinned greatly in that I have done. And now I beseech thee, O Lord, take away the iniquity of thy servant, for I have done very foolishly." So you see, he confesses his sin, right? "For when David was up in the morning, the word of the Lord came unto the prophet Gad, David's seer, saying, Go and say unto David, thus saith the Lord, I offer thee three things, choose thee one of them, that I may do it unto thee. So Gad came to David and told him and said unto him, Shall 7 years of famine come unto thee in thy land? Or wilt thou flee 3 months before thine enemies while they pursue thee? Or that there be 3 days pestilence in thy land? Now advise and see what answer I shall return to him that sent me. And David said unto Gad, I am in a great strait. Let us fall now into the hand of the Lord, for his mercies are great, and let me not fall into the hand of man. So the Lord sent a pestilence upon Israel from the morning even to the time appointed, and there died of the people from Dan even to Beersheba 70,000 men. And when the angel stretched out his hand upon Jerusalem to destroy it, the Lord repented him of the evil and said to the angel that destroyed the people, It is enough. Stay now thine hand. And the angel of the Lord was by the threshing floor of Araunah the Jebusite. And David spake unto the Lord when he saw the angel that smote the people and said, Lo, I have sinned and I have done wickedly. But these sheep, what have they done? Let thine hand, I pray thee, be against me and against my father's house." So you see, David was a man that always confessed his sin and was quick to repent. All right, so in closing, we see that the Great Bible of 1539 was the first authorized version of the Bible in English, right? And it preceded the King James Bible, you know, which you know, when translated, says that David was ruddy. But the Great Bible of 1539 says that David was brown, right? So the significance of all this is that David, we know, comes from the tribe of Judah. We also know who else comes from the tribe of Judah. Yahusha, Yahawashai, Jesus, right? Comes from the tribe of Judah. So when we start looking for a brown-skinned, woolly-haired people who was scattered all over the world, you know what I mean, and sold in slavery with yokes of iron upon their neck, it makes the Bible come to life, and we pretty much understand prophecy a little bit better, right? So that's the significance of all this. So, you know, when people start saying, oh, well, color doesn't matter, you know, you got to be one who understands truth. And just like we talk about with King David, when he was told that he had done something wrong or that he was in the wrong, he confessed his iniquity, right? So when you have been taught wrong, you've been taught wrong, right? But now whether you choose to live a lie, you know, or whether you choose to stand for truth, that's on you. And you will be judged for it. Once you heard, you know. Now God requires it from you. With that being said, y'all have a blessed and wonderful day. Peace.